So active mass. So we should know what is this active mass. So it is nothing but it is the molar concentration of, or active mass is the molar concentration of the reacting substances. So reacting substances in the sense which is actually participating in the reaction. Okay. So active mass is the molar concentration of reacting substance which is actually participating in the reaction. So a simple formula is there for this. So active mass equal to number of moles divided by volume in liters, divided by volume in liters, divided by volume, that will be fine. Okay. And I will tell you why this is used. But before that, at equilibrium, we know that the ratio of Kf by Kb, forward reactant constant and backward reactant constant, is equal to Kc. Kc is nothing but our equilibrium constant respectively. Correct? Now, I will tell you what is the importance of this. And in what entrance problem or what problem this is used? Very important. This actually asks in all the examination, one question will definitely come. I can guarantee you this thing. So I'm going to describe that question and I'll be helping you out in this. The questions come like this. Let A moles. So instead of this A moles and all, there'll be numbers. So I will be explaining to you in the problem, okay? Yeah. A moles of PCl5 be taken in a closed vessel of 1 volume V liters. Suppose X mole of mole is dissociated at equilibrium. So this is going to come for your entrance or board, anything this will come. I'm going to circle, which is important here. A, V, and X. These are important for us. And they will give you the reaction also in this. PCl5, that is gaseous, equilibrium sign. PCl3, again gaseous. Plus chlorine is gaseous. Okay. So now what I'm going to write is very important and should be applied to all the problems. Okay. So you should write the same thing, initial concentration. So this is a syntax. Or this is an algorithm, whatever it is. Initial concentration. For PCl5, it will be, I'll write down two things, initial concentration at equilibrium, then active mass. Okay, so these three things. Initial concentration, write down here A, here 0 and 0. At equilibrium, write down A minus X. X, because you should subtract, correct? X moles is dissociated, that's the reason. active mass is nothing but this by volume. We had the formula, right? Number of moles by volume thing. So A minus X by volume. Here will be X by V. So very easy stuff to remember. A minus X by V, and this is V, this is X by V, X by V, and this is also X by V. Fine. So they can ask you, what is the active mass of PCl5? They can ask you, what is the active mass of PCl3? They can ask you, what is the active mass of chlorine? So these are the kind of questions which will be coming for the Indians, and very easy also to do it. Okay, so this particular thing, whichever I'm ticking, this we have to study compulsory. These three things. It will remain same. This from a previous entrance examination paper, I have just taken it down. That's it. Okay. Now, suppose they tell us to apply the water tell. They tell us to find Kc. Okay. Suppose in this question, if they tell us to find Kc, what is Kc? Product by reactant. Product by reactant. So product, we got two products here. One is PCl3, another is the chlorine gas. And the reactant is PCl5. Okay. So Kc is nothing but X by V into the same X by V by A minus X by V. So for simplifying, we'll get Kc is equal to X square by A minus X into V. So this we have to put in our formula box. Only this one will come for the exam. Either this or whatever I'm underlying now. This one, this one, this one. But we have to know which one, even the A, everything we have to know. Okay. Initial concentration, everything we have to know. Now coming to the most important part in this. The Lake-Chartier's principle. Okay, so this basically meaning any chemical reaction at equilibrium. Okay, suppose any stress is there. Suppose let us take any chemical reaction and it is at equilibrium and any stress is there to that. Okay, so the equilibrium will shift in such a way that the stress is reduced. For example, when we are studying this particular thing, if you are feeling so much stress, then we, what we'll do, we'll listen to music, correct? So that we have to study as well as we have to be stress free. So same way, how do we write a definition of this? When a chemical reaction at equilibrium is subjected to any stress, correct, then the equilibrium shifts in that direction such that this stress is reduced, in which the effect of the stress is reduced. Fine. So let's see, what are the major factors in this thing? So there are only three factors which leads to a change in equilibrium. The first one is change in temperature. Change in temperature. Okay. Suppose if it is at equilibrium, okay. So we know that both endothermic and exothermic, both exo and endo happen simultaneously when at equilibrium. Correct. So suppose if I'm increasing the temperature, what will happen? It would shift the equilibrium in the direction of endothermic. It would shift. Again, I'm using the same word in the definition so that you will be able to relate. Shift the equilibrium in the direction of endothermic. So next one, obviously common sense. If I decrease the temperature, then equilibrium will shift towards exothermic. That's it. So this is a change in temperature thing. Suppose if it is a change in concentration. Effect of concentration. So one is temperature, other is concentration, other is pressure. Okay. So one by one, we will see that. So if I increase the concentration of reactants, reactant concentration is increased. Okay. Fine. Then equilibrium will shift in forward direction. Equilibrium shifts in forward direction. Suppose I am decreasing the concentration of the reaction, of the reactant. Then equilibrium will shift in backward direction. So these things, even in entrance, they can try to confuse us and ask. Okay, so we have to be very confident on these things. Last one, effect of change in pressure. So again, I'm going to use the arrow mark. Increase in pressure. Okay, shifts equilibrium in the direction of lesser number of gas molecules. Direction of lesser number of gas molecules. If I decrease the pressure, it shifts the equilibrium direction of larger number of equilibrium shifts to larger or greater number of gas molecules. So again, I'm using this symbol so that we will remember for a long time. That's it. Then suppose this is mainly for the entrance point of view. They may ask, what is the effect of catalyst? So catalyst, we know it either increases or decreases the rate of reaction. Okay. So if it's not only that catalyst, meaning it always increases. Okay, some of the catalysts which decrease the rate of reaction is what? It's called poison. Okay, so catalyst, what is the effect of catalyst on equilibrium? They'll give some four options to confuse us. The answer of this is no change in equilibrium. No change in equilibrium, or equilibrium remains constant. Okay. And one more thing they can ask, the same thing is, what happens if I add inert gases? So effect of inert gases or if I add or effect of addition of inert gases, addition or adding inert gases. So there won't be any change in equilibrium if it is at constant volume. Okay. But if it is with respect to pressure, then obviously there will be change. If it is respect to pressure, then there will be change. Because increase in pressure will deal with what? Correct? So if it is an increase in pressure, it will deal with where there is lesser number of gas molecules. Decrease in pressure, decrease in shift to increase in number of gas molecules. Those things we have to look, this and this one. Then something for the entrance again. Because teachers in school may not give you these many things for acids and bases. Okay. So very important for the entrance point of view, whatever I'm telling now. The first one, Arrhenius definition. Arrhenius definition for acids and bases. So we know acid gives what? H plus ions in aqueous solutions. Acid gives H plus ions in aqueous solution. Correct? Base give OH minus ion. Again, I'm saying from the basic so that we will know completely what is it. That's it. Second one, some of you guys might be hearing for the first time. Bronsted-Lowry definition. So according to this guy, Bronsted-Lowry. Entrance, this has been asked numerous times, this particular name. Okay, so according to him, acid is what? A proton donor. Base is proton acceptor. This is an entrance favorite question. Fine. So I'm not going to discuss about the strong acid and weak acid. That we have to study. Okay.